Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to this tutorial series. Now, in this episode, we are going to create our App Store Connect app for creating our in-app purchase IDs. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. Now, you can see in the app that there are plenty of pages where we need to add our in-app purchase IDs. We will get to that in just a moment. For now, let us just go into App Store Connect and create our app. And inside that app, let's create our in-app purchase IDs. So let's select account here and App Store Connect. Let's go to App Store Connect. Okay, and now we want to create an iOS app. So let's select My Apps. Rather yet, let me just, I believe I am, yes, there we go. So let's click on plus. Let's create a new app. So that is what we are selecting here. Let's wait for it to load up. Let's select iOS. And name, okay, let's choose English US. Let's choose a bundle ID. So let's just scroll all the way down here and let's find Rebeloper Messages tutorial. It's kind of hard for me, but I will fast forward this. There we go. Let's select that. And let's add our SKU number here without any spaces. And I will give full access for our user access. So let's create this. Let's just wait for it. And finally, we are able to create our in-app purchases. So let's go into features and select in-app purchases. Well, it's automatically selected for you. Now let's go back to Xcode a little bit, because I want to show you what we are going to create now. So first of all, this case zero returns an all stickers in-app purchase ID. Now, if you do have, app has only one non-consumable in-app purchase enabled, so this is set to true, then you only need to provide this in-app purchase ID, because all of the stickers will be unlocked if this is purchased. And of course, if this is set to true, all of the UI elements are set accordingly. So you will see only a buy now button at the top right corner of your app. So let's create this, but I will change this to be tutorial. Okay, and let's just copy it out and let's create a new non-consumable. So let's hit create here. Reference name. Okay, here is the product ID and let's make it tier 1. Display name. It should be the same as the reference name or whatever you would like. Remember, the reference name is just for your reference in App Store Connect, and the display name is what is used inside your app when users purchase your products. So unlock all the stickers. That is fine for the description. Okay, let's choose a screenshot. So I will choose a dummy screenshot for now. What you should do is make a screenshot of your shop inside the app. So let me just go here and add a dummy screenshot. Let me just find something here. There we go. So let's just drag and drop this here and there. Okay, you will need to change this to the actual screenshot of your shop. Okay, and that seems all clear. Okay, now here we have our product ID. So where else do we need to add it? So let's go back to Xcode and let's go into our Rebeloper store config. Okay, and here under item 0, you can see that we have our non-consumables for all stickers. So let's just paste that in there and let's leave non-consumable. Now item 1 is again a non-consumable, but that is for category 2. So we don't need to bother with that. So now we have this product ID for all the stickers. Now again, you need to make sure that this is set up under the case 0 and your app has only one non-consumable purchase is set to true. Okay, and let me just go to the Rebeloper store setup and let me just go and set product 0 as the actual ID that I have just created, and that should work okay. So let's build and run and see if we do get that buy all button appear. Okay, let's click on discover more stickers, and as you can see here we have our locked categories and so on. If we tap on buy, it says buy all. Of course this is in the simulator, so it will not work. Let me just tap on it. Maybe it is the operation couldn't be completed because this is in the simulator, so you can't purchase in the simulator. So go ahead and test it out on a real device. Okay, and that is it for the old stickers. So let's just stop this and go back to our setup and set app has only one non-consumable in-app purchase to false, because I want to show you how you can create more than one in-app purchases, and that is for, let's say, category 2. If you leave this category 1 intact, like an empty string, then it means all of the stickers have been set to be unlocked. So let me just go to the stickers data plist file. As you can see, it says it has an image name and so on. We will cover that in later videos, but it says is locked is a no. And all of the items that are in category 1, they are all set to no. Let me just go all the way down till we go to category 2. And as you can see, all of them have the is locked set to no. And with category 2, it says yes, that is the first locked sticker. Okay, so that is that. And here we have category number one. It basically sets up the button and the color and the display name, but we will talk about that in the next video. Okay, let's go back to setup and let's create a new in-app purchase. So let's make this tutorial category 2. Okay, let's just copy this, and this is for the category 2 in-app purchase. So it will unlock all of the logged stickers inside category 2. So you could have some free stickers in there if you chose to. Okay, let's go back. Let's create a new in-app purchase. Okay, let's click on there. Again, a non-consumable. Let's create this. And let's add the product ID because it's in my clipboard. And let's see, unlock category 2. Now you will most probably have a more descriptive reference name. So let's choose tier 1 again, add the display name, and okay, that is the description. And once again, we need a screenshot, and I will add in this dummy screenshot. Once you have your shop ready, you can simply add this new screenshot in there. And let's save this. And now let's take a look at this new product ID. Let's copy this out. And let me show you where you need to add this in the code. So first of all, you need to add it in the setup. So that is where we have already changed that. and you need to go to Rebeloper Store Setup, go to the product 2, and then go to Rebeloper Store Config, and again for our item 2, let's just add this category. And of course, you should have this as a non-consumable. Now, that is all for non-consumables, and you can go ahead and add as much categories as you'd like. Let's go back to our setup. This can be edited. You don't have to have 15. You could have just 2, or you could have 50. It doesn't really depend. Now, I won't go and create all of these, because these are just the same as we did for the category 2. What I do want to go through is creating subscriptions, okay? And for that, we just need to set app uses subscription in app purchases to true, okay? So make sure that app uses in app purchases is set to true. App has only one non-consumable in app purchases set to false, and app uses subscription in app purchases is set to true. Now, where can you add all of these in app purchases? Well, first of all, it is in the Rebeloper Store setup. Of course, again, you need to add or delete all of these. And here you have three groups. So groups are like weekly, monthly, or quarterly, or even yearly. And here you have to add your group ID. So we just create this first one, tutorial. Okay, tutorial. So it's com.rebeloper.rebelopermessages.tutorial.group1 and subscription 1. Okay, let me just copy this out and go back to our browser. And now let's create a subscription. So let's click on this plus button, and now it will be an auto-renewable subscription. So let's click on create here. And the reference name, let's say weekly stickers, and the product ID, I am just going to paste it in there, and let's click on next. Now here we have our subscription group reference, and that is stickers. Okay, let's create them. And let's just wait for it to be created, and then let's see what else do we need to add. Okay, there we go. So here we have our weekly stickers, and let's choose a duration, and that is 1 week, and let's add our subscription prices. Okay, let's save first. After that, let's add our subscription prices. I would choose tier 1. It doesn't really matter. It depends on your price that you want to set for your stickers. So let's just wait for that to finish. And then just scroll all the way down and let's hit create. Subscription price was created. Okay, now let us just save this. And we will be taken back to our subscription. Okay, let's just wait for that. And of course, you can create more than one group of subscriptions. What you need to do is go back to Xcode and just rename this, or not rename this, add another subscription with group 2. So that is why we have, again, this dot group 1. Okay, so let's go back. It's still saving. Well, sometimes it has this glitch. Let me just refresh. Let's reload this. I have found App Store Connect to be real glitchy inside Google Chrome, so maybe you should use Safari. Okay, we have our subscription prices. Let's add our localization, and I will add English US. Subscription display name, let's say weekly stickers, and get the unlocked stickers weekly. Okay, and let's just scroll all the way down to the screenshot, and again add our screenshot. Make sure you add the screenshot that is for this in-app purchase. So let's click on save now. And it says missing metadata. So let's just add our localization for the subscription group. So let's click on that and add a new localization. It will be English US. Subscription group display name, like it says stickers. And that's it. I believe that is it. Let's save this and we should be ready with our in-app purchase. It says yes, ready to submit. So let's just go back to Xcode and see where else do we need to add this in-app purchase ID. Okay, and first of all, let's go to Rebeloper Store Config. And I believe it's item 11. Yes, that is it. And we need to just paste that in there and make sure the kind is subscription and automatically renews is set to yes. And that is, I believe, all. Yes, make sure you create this auto renewable subscription ID in an array. So if you have, let's say, free subscriptions like I do have now, make sure that they are all added to these auto renewable subscription group 1 IDs. And if you have, of course, group 2, then you should create another string. So basically, group 1 is more than enough for our case. Okay, so I believe that is it for our in-app purchases. So again, make sure that our app user subscription in-app purchases is set to true. You need to add your stickers data, in the Rebeloper store config. You add again the in-app purchase ID, and of course, as this is a no-brainer, you need to set some stickers to be logged. So make sure at least one sticker is logged, so it's set to yes. But that is topic for the next video. We are going to talk about the categories data plist and the stickers data plist files. Okay, now that is it for me today. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell to get notified of new videos coming out. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.